Hello people, today I'm gonna show you my experience with MLDeformer and using it in Unreal Engine to pass on some deformations that you cannot really easily connect there. So let's start. I've prepared a little Maya scene where I have a mesh which is skin bind to a few joints, and also there are several things applied on top of it. So first of all, there is a C-muscle system which basically connects some muscles that I've made in Maya, and it's a simple Maya muscles that are basically just nerves with a few advanced properties. Another thing that I have a blend shape connected to pose space deformation, and on top of it I've added delta mesh just to relax the geometry and smooth it out while it deforms. So let's see what do we have here. So there is a simple animation, and you can see that muscles are activated and they bulge the skin. Let me hide the muscle object so you can see better. I exaggerated it at some parts just for you to be able to see stuff. So for example, in here, in this pose, if I turn on the muscle system, you can see on which areas it works. So same for delta mesh. And the blend shape that I made works in this pose, which basically pushes out a little bit the elbow geometry. And I also, with this muscle, I created a group which creates self-collision in this area where the lower arm meets the upper arm. So basically, it helps us to avoid that penetration. Here it is. What do we need to create a ML deformer in Unreal, and which data do we need to prepare? So first of all, of course, we need skeletal mesh, which we already have. We also need to create a lambic cache, which will provide the training base for MLDeformer. And we need some animation that will just serve us to preview stuff. The good thing with MLDeformer is you can basically, as you saw, you can basically pass any deformer which is not supported directly in Unreal. So for example, you can use dual quaternion skinning, you can use delta mesh or any other deformer like tension, you can use clusters, you can use Maya muscles, you can use even close simulation. It depends on the task, and it can be easily packed into the cache that will be used as a train base and will improve your deformation. So if we consult Unreal Engine documentation, you can see that you have there a recommendation to use Maya plugin. Let me quickly grab it. It's called Autodesk Maya plugin setup, and you can find the information on this page. What I will show you is a kind of simplified approach. Of course, it is less precise and might generate some glitches, so I highly recommend using this, but for preview purposes, simple animation is enough. So we will do what we will do next is just export a lambic cache, and we need to export selected mesh. You can also export all if you have many meshes, but because I have additional objects like my muscle, I just need to export selection. And there are a few important settings that you need to turn on for it to work. You need to write the UVs and you need to write face sets. Might take a few seconds to export the cache because it basically exports geometry at every frame. And what I would recommend is to prepare, if you are not using the plugin, to prepare the animation which shows a lot of movement for the area you wanna train the deformation for. Okay, let's move to Unreal Engine. As you can see, I already did all of the steps, but I will repeat it for the demonstration purposes. So I already imported the skeletal mesh and automatically created a skeleton for it. So here it is. I also imported separately the animation, where basically you can see how mesh looks if we only have skin cluster applied. We have some problematic areas around here, the armpit and the front part of the torso is very stretched due to linear skinning deformation. And we will fix it in a second. Next thing you need to do is to create the ML Deformer asset. You go to Animation, Deformers, ML Deformer. And in your newly Deformer asset, you will need to load a few things. So you need to load your skeletal mesh, you need to load your animation sequence, and it's not the animation that you are using for previewing, it's the animation that was either generated by Maya plugin or specific animations that you made for training purposes. And the second thing you need to input here is your geometry cache. After you imported it, check that your orientation, the orientation of your character in here is the same as a skeletal mesh. So it's, for example, it stands looking up, because otherwise you will not get the correct training data. After you did all of the steps, you can change the settings, you can consult the documentation which one works best for you, and you can already see, like if you scroll through the animation, you can already see these little green lines, which is basically the deltas. So they are showing you which areas will be changing their deformation the most. So you can already preview it. And then you just press train model. And depending on how heavy your cache is and how many frames your training animation have, you will have different time of training it. So I will pause the video while it finish. Here you go, we see that training is completed successfully. Now we can switch from training to testing, and here you will be able to preview the results of your work. So the heat map shows you which areas were affected, and you can basically see like how your animation looked before and after with ML Deformer applied. So you can save the asset. One thing I noticed that sometimes you can see that your deltas are incorrect, like a few polygons or a few vertices just are flying all over the area, and they are definitely not providing the correct result. So there are a few settings that you need to turn on here on a Alembic cache while you're importing. So if I choose re-import, you need to untick flatten tracks. And you need to have store imported vertex number on. And if you see that your deltas are not correct, try turning on this apply constant topology optimization, so you will get better results. If to connect your ML Deformer to your skeletal mesh for your character, in a blueprint you need to do a few things. So first of all, you need to, in skeletal mesh, you need to enable the mesh deformer and choose the deformer graph that supports ML Deformer. So I choose the default one just for demonstration purposes. You can build your own actually and compose whatever deformation chain you need for your purposes. And second, you need to add ML Deformer component here in the blueprint and just connect your ML Deformer asset in here in this field. And that's it. Thanks.